Okay, moving on to the next segment of today's show. As you guys know, the NFL schedule for 2020 actually dropped last night, and it is still unknown if we're going to have NFL football for the 2020 season. But if we do, I did pick 10 games from the schedule that dropped last night that really catch my eye as we move forward to the 2020 season. And I want to tell you guys a little bit about those games. So before we get started, haven't had equalizer music in a little while. Boys, hit the music, and here we go. Still waiting on them. I'm sorry. Here we go. All right. So the 10 games that really stand out to me. How about the first game of the season? Week one, Deshaun Watson and the Houston Texans head to Arrowhead Stadium to take on the defending Super Bowl champion, Kansas City Chiefs, in a in an AFC Championship game rematch. And I'm very fascinated by this game for a couple reasons. Number one, I feel like just because of how many different comebacks the Kansas City Chiefs team really had last season, I feel like people do forget that they were down 24-0 in the AFC Championship game against the Houston Texans, and they could have easily just gave up and lost that game. And, you know, Deshaun Watson is that good, and it's going to be cool to see, like, what exactly the Texans look like. We all know that so far this offseason, they have been in the news for a little bit, but not really for the right reasons when you consider that Bill O'Brien traded DeAndre Hopkins to the Arizona Cardinals. That was a trade a lot of fans just around football really didn't like. So when you combine those two elements and you think that no matter how bad Bill O'Brien is as a coach, he has won a decent amount of games. He's gotten the Texans to the playoffs over the last couple seasons, and I feel like just because of the moves the Houston Texans made so far this offseason, everyone is just very quick to judge Bill O'Brien as a coach when he has gotten his team to the playoffs over the last couple seasons. And I think Deshaun Watson is the quarterback that can win you know, games by himself, and I'm very fascinated to see how exactly the Houston Texans start next season in Kansas City. All right, moving on to the next game. If you've noticed, it's going to be a common trend that the Kansas City Chiefs are on this list. And I'll talk about their second game, and that is their Week 3 Monday Night Football game against the Baltimore Ravens. Another thing not a lot of people realize about the Kansas City Chiefs' 2019 Super Bowl winning season is that they only played the Baltimore Ravens once. And it was very early on, before Lamar Jackson really hit that, okay, I'm the MVP of the league, I'm the best player in the league type confidence, and the Kansas City Chiefs ended up winning that game. Patrick Mahomes has actually never played a game in his career in Baltimore, and that's why I think this game is so fascinating, is because Mahomes in his career is 2-0 against Lamar Jackson, but both games have been at Arrowhead, and these are clearly the two best teams in the AFC. I know a lot of people have, you know, including myself, like Pittsburgh, a lot of people have been on the Denver Broncos bandwagon, but these two teams were clearly the best two teams in the AFC last season, and right now there is no clear-cut third. If you're ranking the best teams in the AFC, it's Chiefs, Ravens, and then a big gap, and it'll be cool to see these two teams play against each other on Monday Night Football in prime time. Moving on to the next game, we'll talk about one more Chiefs game against an AFC opponent. How about Week 6, Thursday Night Football, Chiefs at Bills? Anyone who's listened to this podcast before knows that I am just not that high on the Buffalo Bills compared to a lot of other people. I think they're fine. I just don't trust their quarterback to make the proper plays down the stretch and win games. And in order to win this game against the Kansas City Chiefs, Josh Allen is really going to have to score the ball. I don't care how good the Buffalo Bills defense is, right? The Kansas City Chiefs are putting up like at least 23 points in their sleep basically every game. And I feel like when you look at this matchup, the Bills are going to have to do the same thing no matter how good a defense they play. And they're going to have to still really show a lot of people, including myself, that they are a legit contender in the AFC. I'm not really that quick to judge that statement because I just don't know if it's true or not. I'm not picking the Bills to win the AFC division, the AFC East over New England that quickly. And I think they're going to have to show against the good opponents, which they couldn't do last year, that they're very good. And I think they're going to have an opportunity to do that against Kansas City. Let's go to another non-Kansas City game. AFC-NFC, how about Week 4, 1 o'clock on CBS, the Browns and Baker Mayfield head to Dallas to take on the Cowboys. And the Cowboys are a team that I feel like anytime they're playing a meaningful meaningful opponent, their game is going to be on primetime or the top screen TV because we know they're the Dallas Cowboys. We know how many fans they have, all that stuff. But this game against Cleveland really stands out to me because I do feel like both of these teams are in a very similar spot. Both of these teams, right, have first-year coaches. Both of these teams have quarterbacks that are under a little bit of scrutiny right now, whether it's Baker in Cleveland with his performance and whether it's Dak Prescott in Dallas with his contract situation. And the thing for me, when I look at the situation a little more closer, is that both of these teams are very talented. I don't think anyone's denying that. But for some reason, we're still not sure if they can make the playoffs. And that's a big problem. If both Cleveland or Dallas and one of them doesn't make the playoffs, they're in big trouble and their fans are not going to be happy. And I think to both of these teams, every game just means so much to them. And I think when they lose games, they're not supposed to lose. Their coaches are going to be under scrutiny. And when they play each other, the fireworks will go off. So Dallas and Cleveland, week 4 is a game that stands out to me early. Also, we'll go back to Kansas City. How about week 12? CBS, Kansas City versus Tampa Bay. Brady versus Mahomes. Brady in his career is 2-1 against Patrick Mahomes, which is solid, but Brady got the best of him in the AFC Championship game. But all three of those meetings came when Tom Brady was a member of the New England Patriots. Now, I actually think Tom Brady and the Buccaneers have the offense to maybe keep up with the Kansas City Chiefs. They're going to have the offensive ability to score points with Mike Evans and Chris Godwin pushing the ball down the field. And I really like this team, man. I really do. I think the Buccaneers will be solid, and I think they will have a very nice competitive matchup with the Kansas City Chiefs. Always cool to see Brady versus Mahomes play each other. They've had some history in the past. Moving on to the Week 8 game between Seattle and San Francisco. This game is actually in Seattle, and the reason why I picked it was because the Seattle Seahawks last season actually had... I feel like it's another element of the NFL season that not a lot of people like to talk about, and that is that the Seattle Seahawks were literally 1 yard away from winning the NFC West. And if that yard goes their way, then Seattle could have made the Super Bowl just as easy as San Francisco did. Russell Wilson is that good, and I do think if Seattle would have stayed healthy last season, they definitely would have had a shot to beat the Green Bay Packers in that NFC divisional round. But these two teams don't like each other. We know the rivalry they had going back to the Richard Sherman days of him being in Seattle, and it's cool to have this rivalry reinforced. There's kind of, some new faces of the rivalry when you look at Jimmy Garoppolo, Kyle Shanahan, and Nick Bosa on one side, and these two teams play twice. Both of the meetings are going to be very good. But last year in CenturyLink Field, the 49ers won the NFC West title by 1 yard. And I do believe if Seattle gets in the end zone, if Jacob Hollister gets in that end zone, gets that 1 yard, I do believe there's a very good shot that San Francisco does not end up representing the NFC in the Super Bowl last year. That's how important that 1 yard was. So this is a game, week 8, 4:30 on Fox, that will mean a lot. Let's go to another AFC versus NFC battle, and this one's going to be in prime time. Monday Night Football in week 13, the Buffalo Bills go to San Francisco. I said when I was talking about the Kansas City Chiefs Buffalo Bills game that the Buffalo Bills early and really just throughout the whole season are really going to have to prove to me that they can compete with some of the best teams in football. We saw last year in that playoff game against the Houston Texans that even though the Buffalo Bills played decent throughout the whole way, their quarterback couldn't make enough plays to win them the game. And Josh Allen just looked scared in that game, man. And the only reason why the Houston Texans won that game was because Deshaun Watson was clearly the better quarterback. A big reason, and I'll admit it, as to why I'm so down on the Buffalo Bills is because of that game. I just can't get that game out of my head. And San Francisco is one of the best teams in football. They have one of the best defenses in football. And especially when you're playing in their crib on Monday Night Football, you're going to have to come ready to play or else you're getting blown out. So it's going to be interesting to see how exactly the Bills look in that game on Monday Night Football against San Francisco. Let's go back to the Chiefs for a sec. How about this? The Kansas City Chiefs in week 15 go to New Orleans to take on the Saints. And similar to the Bills, you guys know I'm really not as high on the New Orleans Saints as most. I think I'm not as high as on the New Orleans Saints compared to most. I think when you look at the Saints, they're good, but I think they're, it's very hard to get up for a fourth straight year in a row. And this week one game against Tampa Bay is going to be good because division rivalry makes the game, you know, very important early. And you just have Tom Brady's first game as a Tampa Bay Buccaneer going up against Drew Brees. That is something that every single football fan is going to want to watch. And I think these two teams are going to be really competing the whole way in a very tough NFC South. That's what makes this whole Tom Brady to Tampa Bay situation so interesting for me, is the fact that he's, you know, is going to be thrown right into the fire. He's going to be expected to win right away for a franchise that, let's face it, over the last couple years, just hasn't won anything at all, and the schedule is very tough to start. We all know how tough the NFC South is. We all know that the NFC South actually plays the AFC West, so Tampa Bay will have to deal with Kansas City. They'll have to deal with Denver, and this game against New Orleans for Kansas City and the Saints, Week 15 is going to be good because, similar to Tampa Bay, Drew Brees and the Saints have the offensive ability to score and catch up with the Chiefs. I'm down on the Saints, but this is a game that is definitely going to mean a lot, and I'm really looking forward to it. Finally, the last game on this list. How about week 13 on Fox, Thursday Night Football? Dallas at Baltimore. This is an interesting game for many reasons. Kind of similar to what I said about the Browns, anytime you're facing the Dallas Cowboys and you're a somewhat decent team, it's going to be in prime time. But the fact is that the Baltimore Ravens and Lamar Jackson were just such a fun story across the whole National Football League last year. And they're going to be facing the Dallas Cowboys at home in prime time. And I feel like if the Dallas Cowboys fans, if things aren't going well for Dallas at that late in the season, they're going to probably say to themselves, all right, Dak, you want to get paid like one of the best quarterbacks in the National Football League, then you need to go out against one of the best teams and defenses in the National Football League on the road in a big primetime game and play well. And if I'm a Cowboy fan and if I'm looking at this from any perspective, I think those expectations are totally fair. If Dak Prescott is a very good quarterback, and I do think he deserves to get paid, but at the same time, if you're a Cowboy fan, the only way your team is going to take the next step is if Dak Prescott makes players around him better and he turns into that elite quarterback. And to be honest, I just still haven't seen that yet, and I'm curious to see how exactly he does against such a good and dominant defense like the Baltimore Ravens.